I do it for my kids. I don't do it to worship the devil. I do it because I don't want my kids to miss out. Well, us as parents, this is where we could teach our kids from right from wrong. Because the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 10, says this: "There shall be not found among you anyone that maketh his son or daughter pass through the fire, that seeketh divinations, fortune tellers, or to observe, or to observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch. This year, all that you see is witches, goblins, all this thing that represents death. But God said to the people of Israel, he told them, do not get involved, don't get entangled, don't be with these people, these occults, don't be like them. Be different. And God said, don't deal with these kind of people. Because the devil is behind all of this. The devil wants you to think that he is the truth, but in reality, he's the father of lies. And you don't want us to know that God holds the future. But if we put our trust and our hope in our God, and in the Bible clearly says in Jeremiah 29:11 that God has a plan for us, for a hope and a future. The devil is a deceiver. He likes to pretend something that he's not. He's trying to get people and get their minds off God, trying to misguide us and direct himself, and he tries to disguise himself in this evil holiday and think that it's fun, it's for the kids, it's for them to get candy, but in reality, we're partaking in an evil day. 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 14, and no wonder, for Satan himself transforms himself into an angel of light. This holiday does not glorify God whatsoever. By the testimony of our own mouths, when we asked earlier, what does this day represent to you? You said it. This doesn't glorify God whatsoever. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 27, don't give the devil a foothold. Because why? By allowing this to come into our life, or by allowing this to happen, we allow the Guzman to deceive us. We allow him to deceive us in many things. Now here goes the part that I want to talk about. Tomorrow, we'll get up, and life goes on. The next day. For me, it's so interesting how we've been on this study on growing up. And we talked about getting away of the old man, putting away the old self, putting away these things. It makes no difference whether you go for Halloween or you don't. It becomes your relationship with God. This is your only time that you could stand different. The rest of the world, the Guzmano, all his people are going to go out and celebrate the devil. This is your only time to stand back and be that peculiar person. Hallelujah. To be that the people that God has called us to be, the salt and the light of the world. Don't even try to say, well, I'm only doing it for the candy. I understand that. You know that. But there's two people that takes this very seriously. The devil and God. Because the Bible says this, that our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities and dark rulers of this world. This is what I need you to understand something, because by having any kind of partaking of this thing without us realizing it, we're partaking of this evil holiday that's dedicated not to God, but to the devil. You go to Walmart, you go to Walgreens, you go to the market, everything that you see, these decorations on the guy's house, nothing. You don't see nothing glorifying God, but you see nothing but death. But the Bible shows that Jesus conquered death. The devil wants you to think that the only thing that there is after life is death. That's a false hope. There's life after death. There's life. There's life eternity. A person will spend it either with God or with the devil. But us as Christians, we have to get out there and preach this gospel. Yeah. Not just wait once a year to have this debate, because this is how you even know this holiday is even from the devil, because Christians debate whether or not that they should go or should they not. There's discord in the church. There's discord in the body. There's no unity in the body of Christ. People are saying, well, you could go, what's the big thing? But in reality, what are we doing if we go out there? Do you think our kids are really missing out on something? We buy our kids candy every day. Our kids have costumes. We buy them things like that every day. Sometimes Isaac's the Hulk or Spider-Man on every day. He beats us up, but it's a different story. But you see what I'm saying? These are things that happen. Why this particular day? Well, people say, well, dress them up as little disciples and stuff like that. No, that's compromising. Because the Bible said it, that the Dusmano, that he disguises himself as the light. He disguises himself as the light. The Dusmano is not going to come to us, say, hey, I'm the devil. No. No. My pastor used to say that he comes with blue eyes and blue jeans. It's not me. He disguised himself as somebody holy, somebody that you know, this is the right way. Because here's the reason why I want to share this with you. In the book of Genesis, chapter 3, we read a story on Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve, they were in perfect unity with God. In God's presence. The Bible says that God used to walk with them. They used to talk to God on a daily basis. Unity, communion with God. And then one day, the Dusmano, as he disguised himself as a serpent. And he came as a serpent, and he was deceiving. The Bible says that he was the most cunning, the most sharpest of all the animals that God created. And he came and he wanted to do something, and he tricked Eve. He tricked Eve. Trick or treat. He tricked her. And they were in for a treat, all right? Because what happened? They were cast out of the very presence of God. They were cast out of the very presence of God, and the Bible says that there were two cherubims protecting God's presence. These are things, the Bible's not going to tell you, don't go for Halloween double shoes. The Bible won't say that. But it goes so far, it goes so behind, there's so much things that are in here. It talks about these dark, evil things. And that goes for us on a daily basis as Christians. We are not to contaminate ourselves. We are not to be entangled with this world. But the Bible says, don't copy the behaviors of this world. Well, I gotta go. Everybody does it. Well, I gotta drink. Everybody does it. Well, I gotta commit adultery. Everybody does it. No, there needs to be a difference. There needs to be a difference between the Christian and the non-Christian. It seems that this whole month we've been talking about stop blending in. Let's grow up. Make a difference. Stop doing this. We need to understand something. We are called God's children. And we have to set the example. The Bible says it. I'll say it again. The Bible says it, that we are the salt of the earth. A city situated on the hill. A light that's supposed to give its light to the whole house. So if we could use this day for the glory of God, let's do it. If we can, let's do it. If we could live the rest of our life for the glory of God, let's do it.
Amen.
This is what God has called us to do. God has called us to be different. God has called us to go out and preach the gospel. There's some churches that say it's okay. It's not that big of a thing. And maybe they're deceived. I don't know. But in reality, how can you tell me that I can't do fortune, but you're telling me to go partake in a holiday that's revolved around that? See what I'm saying? How can you say don't practice sorcery, but then go ahead and take your kids out for a day that's dedicated to that? Don't worship the devil. You got to worship God. Give all glory to God. But then you're telling me that it's okay for me to go and take my kids out for this day? It's wrong. And the same thing with everyday life. We need to get right with the Lord. The finished work of Jesus is accomplished. It's given us salvation. We have life eternal forever and ever. But we need to start doing our part in our relationship. We need to start doing our part for the glory of God. Because the Bible says that whatever we do, whatever it is, we should set our mind on heaven. Not on things of this world. This world is going to end. And all that we have left is God. All that we have left is God. Eternity. We need to get this message out there. Share it with somebody. Maybe you don't have enough time. Well, tomorrow's Halloween and it's hard. Okay. We need to set this example for the rest of our life. For the other things in life. For the other things that doesn't revolve around a holiday. The things that we do on a daily basis. We need to set an example. Remember, we learned something. Why do we need to grow up? It's to edify the body. It's to edify the church. It's to edify your Christian brother, your sister, to grow together in knowing the Lord. The Bible says that when we're together, we should always have a song of hymns. We should always have a blessing on somebody. This is what needs to happen. Before we close and before we do anything, we need to do something tonight. Tonight, us as Christians that know the truth, that not to have anything to do with this holiday, we need to stand in the gap tonight for those who are lost. Because I've seen testimonies today of witches, real life witches. Ones that practice white magic and ones that practice black magic. Guess what? It's the same thing. It's the same thing. Not one is different. But the Guzman, I want you to think that. And I seen that they changed. They gave their life to God. They had to experience something ugly. This woman had to see a baby murdered before her heart was softened. And she gave her life to God. Why? How did that happen? How do you think that? Do you think she was born as a witch? No. She raised up. Her family took her for Halloween. She fell in love with that. Do you want to be responsible? Do I want to be responsible, Papi Mali? Do I want to be responsible for my children to either become witches and devil worshippers? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We have to point them to Christ. And when they get to an age of accountability, that's between them and God. But tonight, we need to stand in the gap for those who are lost. And sadly, yes, Christians. Because me and Alex seen the church a couple of days ago encouraging people to celebrate Halloween. This is a church that people come and glorify God in. And they're saying, go ahead, do it. How? You know what also what happened to the satanic church? Look what else it does tomorrow. Tomorrow. They start praying that Christians marriages would bring. They start praying that evil spirits will enter into the Christian's home. They start praying against, they tell the devil to have his way into the Christian. They pray that he would start making confusion. This is what happens. But we have a God that's great. Amen. We have a God that is alive. We have a God that's the creator of the universe. We have a God, I want you to remember this. Tomorrow, this morrow has a day that's dedicated to him. Was not given to him by God, but given to him by man. But the Guzman knows already his outcome. He already knows what's in store for him. He knows that he's eternal condemned into hell. He knows that. He knows that. And he's trying to confuse God's children. He's trying to confuse them and bring them where he's going to be at. Guys, I'm not just talking about Halloween. About our life in general.